What's up, guys? It's your girl, Emily Curl, and right now I am joined by Trevor Daniel. Trevor, what's up?
Chilling.
We're just here at iHeart.
Yeah, this is dope.
It's going to be so fun. I'm so excited you're here, and I can't wait to talk to you about so many things that's happened in your life.
Yeah.
But the first one, let's talk about Falling.
Yeah.
An amazing song.
Thank you.
I love listening to it. What has it been like to see such a strong response from your fans?
It's wild. it's just crazy. That's pretty much all I can say. It's just, I was sitting in my house one day and then all of a sudden I'm just like, wow, these stats are really going crazy. I've been like pacing the floor back and forth ever since. I'm starting to get into a routine now though, so it's pretty cool.
There's an interesting story with Falling too, because it sort of had a resurgence on TikTok a few months after its release. Mm-hmm. When did you first notice that it was trending again, and how did that feel?
It was like a year, exactly, almost.
Oh, a year after its release?
Yeah, pretty much. That's when I started really noticing. My friend came over, she was like, hey, you know, your song is all over TikTok. And I knew about TikTok, but I kind of got off of social media for a minute to focus on the album. And then I downloaded TikTok again, and it was like every five videos. It was nuts.
Was there a video that stood out to you?
There's a dog skateboarding to it. it's a little, I don't know what kind of dog it is, but it's a tiny dog. And it's kind of fat, it's cute. It's just like skateboarding on a...
Do you use TikTok now because of that?
I just like scroll through it, but I haven't made a video yet for some reason. But I need to do that.
I want to talk about Falling the song specifically. What was your inspiration behind the song?
You know, just an ex-girlfriend. I was just like, yo, you know what? I'm not doing this again. It was just mind games or whatever. And then, like, 2 weeks later, I'm in driving school, and then I meet this other girl.
In driving school?
Yeah.
Y'all met in driving school?
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
Well, how are y'all taking the test next to each other?
Yeah, she was just, like, sarcastic, and I don't know, I thought it was cute.
What do you think, like, the song now means to you, now that it's skyrocketed into this new level?
Yeah, it's like 50-50 breakup, 50-50 happy. It's kind of like the back and forth in my head, where it's just, and I'll never give my all again. After I just said I'll give you everything, it's just kind of like the back and forth in my head.
Yeah.
It still means the same thing to me. It's just crazy performing it and just like seeing everybody know the lyrics and, you know, like last night I cried, you know.
Yeah, that's okay. I want to talk about last night, because you played a sold out show at Mercury Lounge in New York.
Yeah, throughout the show I kept crying. Like, I kept like tearing up. It was wild.
When did you first be overcome with emotion on stage?
The first song. We were coming back and then I just saw all the people. For like 10 seconds, my heart started racing. I was a little bit nervous, but then grabbed the mic, kind of got halfway through the crowd and then it went away. I started tearing up a little bit, but I'm like, dude, chill. Gain your composure. And then halfway through the set, it started like trying to come out. I'm like, dude, no. And then like right before Falling or wherever that was in the set, where I was just like, look, dude, I'm trying not to cry right now. Like, I just had to say it so everybody just knew.
I'm sure that's special for the audience though, watching, like to see you on stage be emotional for this show.
I hope so.
They were a good crowd? They were fun?
They were an amazing crowd. They were so fun. And then like whenever we got in there, it was just super cool to just jump around with them and just like sing with everybody. It was fun.
You were telling me that your very first show in New York, that after the show you had everyone sign your shoe.
Right.
Where was that show? Tell me about it.
So I was at Rough Trade in Brooklyn. Everybody just signed the shoes. And there was like 40, maybe 50 people there.
And how long ago was that?
That was like March of 2019.
So, were you gonna have everyone sign your shoes last night?
Well, we thought about it and then we sold out. And then we were like, yo, that's a lot of shoes. Originally, I was just gonna wear some Air Forces and I changed my fit last minute because of it. I'm like, no, I gotta wear these. What am I thinking? These.
I love the remix that you did with Black Bear.
Thank you.
What was that collaboration like?
When he started coming out with music, I started listening to him. I was a big fan, so it was really cool to get to link up with him on that. And now we're talking about when both of our songs go top 10, we're gonna get a yacht for a day and just like enjoy the day.
Y'all should just film a music video while you're at it too, just on the yacht.
We'll probably talk about that actually, so heck yeah.
Now, who else do you credit as your musical influences?
You know, I would watch movies and just the way things look would inspire ideas, and just people. Like my parents and stuff, just the random things they would show me.
Is that a goal of yours, to have one of your songs be in a movie soundtrack?
Yes, I really want to do that. I want to make a whole soundtrack for a movie and just like take over that and like, you know, be a little
on that. If Falling could be in one movie right now, which one would you choose?
Oh, any of the Marvel movies. I'm a nerd. Or DC, like I'm just like a big comic book nerd.
Who are some of your dream collaborations?
I want to collab with like Dua Lipa and Taylor Swift just because they're really dope.
We just had an interview with Dua Lipa. She's so cool. Her new album's dropping soon.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited to hear that. I'm really excited to hear that. There's so many people, like Frank Ocean and just Kid Cudi. Taylor Swift.
I mean, you had a big night last night. I was surprised. It's early today, too, right now.
It's super early. Travis Scott.
Yeah.
That's definitely a big one because he's from Houston. Same, so I'm really trying to do that because he's inspired like the whole city. It's crazy.
Yeah. So you have talked about you had a devastating moment in your hometown dealing with Hurricane Harvey, but that was also a moment that encouraged you to pursue music full time. How did that sort of shape you as an artist and the music that you made?
It's kind of weird because you would think it would completely just like suck, but it was kind of refreshing for me, luckily.
Really?
Like it was the weirdest thing. My cousin and I, we like canoed back. It was one, it felt like Jurassic Park. It was kind of weird. We're just like going through my apartment and you could see the water line. It was like about where my chest is when I stand up.
That's so crazy to think about.
It was so wild.
So wild.
But I remember just like going in my room to see if I needed anything else or like if there was anything to save. I got my music stuff. So
that's it. And you feel like that sort of like just restarted this whole new chapter for you.
Yeah, it was kind of crazy. Let's see, here I go again. My bad, sorry.
No, please. I'm gonna start crying with you, truly.
But no, I was just like standing there and I'm like, yo, this is good. This is cool. Like I got my music stuff, I'm chilling. There was people who like just like didn't have anywhere to go. Like at least I had family and stuff, but.
What's it like to go back to Houston? Have you played a show there since?
Yeah, sick. It's just really fun. Everybody just comes and has a great time.
I'm sure that hometown pride too. It's like a feeling like no
so
other.
Super dope.
You're in LA now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
I've been there since October working on the project.
How was that transition for you?
It was weird at first. I'm starting to get used to the traffic, but I don't know if I'll ever 100% get used to it. But
I know every time I go to LA, that's my one thing too. Yeah. I'm so used to subways here. Yeah. I'm like, do I know how to drive? I'm not sure.
Yeah, just I got a friend group now. It's cool.
I want to talk about your music video because I think it's so cool.
Thank you.
To me, it felt like you were numb to your emotions around you, but still going through these different phases of life.
Yeah.
What was your interpretation? What do you kind of hope people who watch take away from it?
Just how like chaotic the headspace was, just like back and forth, and just like I'm sitting there going through all of these emotions and things like that. Things are just happening and I'm just there trying to process it, kind of thing. So
do you feel like you're still at that like headspace in your life, or you feel like you can kind of look back and reflect on that moment when you wrote that song?
I can reflect on it for sure, but you know, that happens all the time. Like most of my music is so back and forth because that's just where my headspace is on a lot of things, especially girls. So it's just like, I shouldn't do this, or yes, or whatever.
Which moment is the most surreal for you so far? Was it last night?
Yeah, last night was dope. Oh, you know what? We heard it on the radio randomly, not expecting it for the first time. And I got on Instagram Live. I was freaking out. I was like, yeah, this is sick.
Scream? Like, how do you feel in that moment? Are you just like in shock?
No, I was in the car with Brandon and we were just talking. And then all of a sudden he's like, yo, stop, listen. I was like, yo, this is crazy. And it was nuts. We were just, yeah.
Oh my God. That's so great. Okay, so Trevor, before we let you go, what's next for you? When's the album? When's everything happening?
Can I say that?
Very
soon.
You can't give us any insider. Are there any collabs on the album, or is that also top secret?
There are, but that's top secret.
Okay.
Top secret information, confidential. I'll let you know soon.
Well, we'll take it. We're excited for you. Excited to hear the album. Trevor Daniel, thank you so much for being here, and thank you guys for watching. And we'll see you next time. Bye. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. Did you like that video? You can check out more over here. And don't forget to subscribe to iHeart right here. And if you're already a longtime fan, make sure you ring the bell down below so you don't miss a single video. Bye guys.